Well, we've got pgAdmin installed and Postgres installed and up and running. So what are we going to do now? Well, in the coming videos, we're going to start to dive a little bit more into some of the internals of Postgres and really understand some things that make Postgres, well, Postgres. Unfortunately, the very first topic we're going to dive into is going to be just a little bit dry, but you have to go through it at some point inside this course. You have to understand it at some point. So what is the topic? Well, it is data types. Remember, we've been creating tables every now and then throughout this course. And when we create a table, we specify the type of data that is going to be inserted into every one of our different columns. So we've been working with, say, our table of products. To create a table like that, we might run the SQL you see over here on the right-hand side. In this case, the data types are serial, varchar, varchar, integer, and integer. Each of these data types is going to attach either some special behavior to a column, in the case of serial, or otherwise, it's going to designate the type of data we can store inside of each of these. So in the case of, say, an integer column, we can only store numbers inside there that do not have a decimal on them. So we cannot store something with a decimal, and we also cannot store something like a string. Only numbers, that's it. So in this video and the next couple, we're going to start to get a better idea of all the different types that are available to us and when to use each of them. All right, so here are some of the different categories of data types we have access to. Now I want to stress the word categories. In, say, the numbers category, there are many different subtypes that we can get access to. So in the world of Postgres, there are just a tremendous number of different data types. You don't really need to memorize each and every one of them. And as a matter of fact, to really be efficient or kind of know what's going on inside of a database, these are probably the only ones you really need to know of off the top of your head. Some of the different number types, date and time types, characters, so essentially strings, and Boolean values. We've kind of already taken a look vaguely at numbers, characters, and Booleans, but we're going to go back through each of these different categories and really understand how to work with each of these different data types. We are going to touch on some of the other different data types over time, but for right now, our focus is going to be on just numbers, date, time, character, and Boolean. Let's start off first with numbers. So inside of the numeric types category, there are many different types that we can make use of. So each of these words on the left-hand side is a type of number that we can assign to a column, and that's going to control the type of value that we can store inside that column. So for example, back over on this diagram, we saw that we made use of the integer, integer, and serial data types. So inside of this ID column, price and weight, we would have to follow the rules of integer and serial. Now there's several different types inside of here, but they fall into roughly three different categories. On the top left-hand side, these are all about storing numbers that don't have any decimal point. On the bottom left-hand side, these are all data types that are about storing numbers without a decimal point that also auto-increment. So we've already seen this with IDs, for example, with the serial data type. It starts off at 1 and then automatically increments every time we insert a new record. And then the final subcategory is numbers with decimal points. And that's all these up here on the top right-hand side. Now, I got to be totally honest with you. All this number stuff and number data types, kind of boring. You still have to know it, but it's kind of boring. So here's how we are going to tackle it. In the next video, I'm going to give you some quick rules to follow whenever you're trying to store numbers. So we're going to say, okay, if you're trying to store this kind of number, use this kind of data type. After that, we're going to go into more detail, but it will be an optional video. So if you find all this talk about numbers to be super dry and super boring, don't sweat it. Just watch the following video, which is going to be hopefully really quick. And then after that, if you're still interested in this topic, we'll go into more detail. So let's take a look at these next two videos in just a moment.